गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर 14 साउंड. ओके, वी स्टडी अबाउट द साउंड. इन आवर डेली लाइफ वी हियर सेवरल साउंड्स लाइक द साउंड ऑफ बर्ड्स एंड एनिमल्स, द साउंड ऑफ मशीन्स एंड व्हीकल्स, द साउंड ऑफ टीवी एंड टेलीफोन एक्सेट्रा. सम साउंड्स आर सच दैट वी ह्यूमन कैन नॉट हियर देम, बट सम एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स आर एबल टू हियर इट. ओके, so we hear so many sounds in the outside on our house and in everything, but some sounds only we are able to hear and some sounds we cannot hear. So what is sound and how is it produced? Means the sound, how is it coming out? Okay, so we learn in this lesson. Already in class 8 you have studied about the sound. Okay, so how does sound produced by a source reach our ears? Okay, how the sound is coming and that sound, how it is reaching our ears? Okay, so a person standing outside cannot hear clearly the sound of a person sitting inside a closed car, a closed bus or a closed room. But when you knock on the door or window of a car, the sound can be heard on both the sides. Why is it so? Okay, so when we are sitting inside the closed room or closed bus, so when some persons knock on the door or window, we hear the sound. So how is it? So for all these questions we now get the answers. Okay, for example, now you do it in your house. Okay, take a scale and keep it on the table like this, and here you just shake half you keep on the table and half you leave it outside, and this side you shake the scale and you can see scale going up and coming down. Okay, so the real scale will be here, but the vibrations we can see. Vibrations means what? So the sound, the scale going up and coming down. Okay, so here now press the scale and leave it. We see that scale starts to vibrate and sound is produced. Scale starts to vibrate and it gives the sound. Now repeat this activity by keeping 30 centimeters, 20 centimeters and 10 centimeters of scale free. What did you experience? Does the length of your scale left free affect the sound produced? Okay, for example, if you tie a metallic wire tightly between the two hooks. Okay, two hooks. Note that here should not be any knot in the wire. Okay, wire should be straight and this is the hook. Okay, so tie this wire two sides. Okay, so after tying, vibrate it using your finger. Vibrate it means what? You just shake this wire. Just shake the wire. Keep your finger and shake the wire and it starts to vibrate. Vibrate means the wire will be here, but it will show as the going up and coming down. Na? So, and can you hear some sound? If yes, then is in this sound different than the sound produced in activity 1? Activity 1 means scale. Now another one you take, rubber. Okay, this is called as a turning fork. This rubber also you shake it and you hear the different sound. Okay, so how the sound is produced means, underline this point, you saw that sound is produced in your body due to vibration. So how the sound is produced, how the sound is coming? Because of the vibrations of the different things. Okay, liquid sounds are different from the solid sounds and gas sounds are different. Okay, liquid means what? Like water variety sound is different from the stone sound. Okay, solid sound and gaseous sound is also different. Okay, so here the important point you should notice is what? The sound is produced because of the vibrations. Okay, because of the vibrations. Understand. So here sound depends on the elasticity of the material. What is the elasticity? Elasticity means you take a rubber or rubber band. You just stretch it out. Stretch it out means you just expand. Okay? You just pull it and then leave it. Then again that rubber will come to its own place. Okay? For example, take this spring. Okay? Here this is the spring. This spring, we stretch it out, okay, stretching with the hands. And when we stretch it out and our expand, make it long and again leave it, it comes to short. It will become short again. It comes to its original place. And again stretch it, expand and it becomes long. Again leave it, it comes near. So, happening like this in the rubber things is called as a elasticity. Okay, this is the elasticity. So sound depends upon the elasticity. So for the rubber things, elasticity means we can make it long and again when we leave it, again it comes to its own place. Okay, so elasticity is that property of material due to which it resists any change in its shape. Resists means stops. It will not accept. When we make it long, again it comes to its original place. Okay, so the shape is not changed and size is not changed. Again it can come to its own place. Okay, that means when the object changes its shape or size or tries to change it due to applied force, then the object tries to resist this change and tries to get back to its original shape due to its property of elasticity. Elasticity means after stretching the rubber or spring, after making long, again it comes back to its original place, is called as a property of elasticity. Okay, so here the more elastic is material, it will try to get back to its original shape quicker. For example, metallic objects are more elastic as compared to objects made of rubber. Here actually rubber has the more elastic, but in the case of sound, okay, in the case of sound, metal things like aluminium or the silver, gold and iron, all this copper, all these things are the metal. Okay, so metallic objects are more elastic as compared to objects made of rubber. Hence it is difficult to pull, bend or change their shape in comparison with rubber. This property of material affects the sound produced from them. Okay, so in the case of a sound, the elasticity of the metals are more than the rubber. If the elasticity is more, we hear more sound according to the sound. If elasticity is less, we hear the less sound. For example, we keep down the bench. Okay, bench is made up of the iron or aluminium metal. Okay, and another one rubber, made of rubber. That rubber things keep down and also iron bench will keep down. From which we hear more sound? From the metal, from the iron table. So it has more elasticity. Rubber has the low sound, but so it has the low elasticity. The length of vibrating, here we are taking the vibrations. Sound comes from the vibrations. If vibration is more, sound will be more. Vibration is less, sound is less. So here for the metallic things, vibrations are more. That means elasticity is more, so that sound is more. In the rubber, vibrations are less. That means elasticity is less, so sound is less. We cannot listen to the sound of vibration of the object below its minimum required length.